Okay, hello, welcome to this week's video. Now, I quit, I am done. I am so done with this nonsense, I am done. And let me tell you why. I totally quit, and in this week's video, I want to ask you, what kind of service provider are you, number one? What kind of leader are you? What kind of trainer are you? Most importantly, what kind of human being are you when it comes to making a difference? This is the scenario. Number one, I did three leadership and strategy sessions. Three, okay? Here is where we introduce leaders and organizations to what we call the rapid influence system. Rapid influence system is the number one system that is guaranteed to not just take performance to the next level, but to create a high performance culture. I did three of them, okay? This year, how many? Three of them. And this is the scenario. Number one, Team A, the leadership was absolutely happy with what we did. The team was absolutely happy. These guys have gone on to do some amazing stuff, okay? The testimonials coming out of here are amazing, okay? Number two, guess what? Company B, the leader was very happy. Yes, the team was super pissed off with me, okay? As in super pissed off. They said, we don't want to see this Coachfield guy ever again, okay? Which is great, not a problem. And we had number three, okay? Leader was very happy. No. Here, the leader was super, super angry with me. But guess what? The team is super, super excited and they're looking forward to the next year. My question to you is, what do you think went wrong? Or what do you think went right? Because we did the same session for all the three. Same thing, same principles. Look, the principles for high performance are the same. The principles for leadership are the same. The principles for execution are the same. Everything was the same. What was the difference, okay? Now, the reason I'm telling you I quit is that I am totally done with working for people who don't understand that it takes work to make things happen. Let us talk about leadership team number one, okay? The leaders are happy, the team is happy. Why? They all embrace the fact that number one, it takes hard work. Number two, it takes clarity. Number three, you got to create a high performance culture. Number four, you have to inspire greatness. Number five, you have to demand excellence. Number six, without the desire to make a difference in the community and everywhere else, nothing works, okay? They embraced it, they're working towards it. Everybody is absolutely 110% super engaged. Let me repeat that for you. Clarity. Okay, everybody's super clear, the vision is clear, what they're going to do is clear. High performance, what it means to them, what high performance culture means to them. They've started to put in place things that are what? Creating a better culture, which what? Which makes sure that people are actually performing, okay? They what? They work like a team, they know what it takes. Most importantly, they've realized, actually one point that I missed, is that everything they do is about creating an experience for the customer that is out of this world. You look at any organization that has done well in the last 15 years, okay? What is it going to have? Customer at the what? At the middle of everything they do, okay? The culture is around the customer. Everything else is around the customer. So this number one team, they did it. Everything is cool. I am now doing some coaching for the leader. And, you know, he's always calling me up and saying, hey, coach, what do we do here? What do we do here? Super happy with it. By the way, let me let you into something. I was super hard on these guys. I went after them like bad ass, okay? If you know anything about me, I say it the way it is. I'm going to kick your ass if I know that if you do things right, you're going to get to the next level. Now, let us look at Company B. The leader was very happy. The team was super pissed off. Why? The leader is foreign, okay? The leader comes in and has got a straight way of doing things, okay? Guess what? When I come in, I hold the team much more to a higher level. I tell them to style up. I tell them to step up. I tell them to stop giving excuses. I tell them to stop, you know, they say, oh, it is the leader. I said, no, have you looked at yourselves? Have you looked to see if you have the right attitude? Have you looked to see that you're executing on what you're supposed to do? Okay, guess what? Some of them, especially those who came from government side of things, they did not like it one bit. You know, I said to them, hey, if you're coming in, you know, and you're doing 8 hours, but we know you're doing 6 hours, that is wrong. And they're like, oh my God, how could Coach Taylor? Shut up, okay? Now, I quit these guys. I said, you know what? I'm not going to deal with these guys anymore. But guess what? Who is happy? The leader. Now, what we got to do is to inspire the team to understand this is what it takes. To do what? To get to the next level. Because nobody likes to work for a company that is not winning. Nobody likes to work for a company that is not making great things happen, okay? And this here, this guy here, the leader, is going to create an environment where everybody is thriving. Those who do not step up, they're going to have to go back to the community so that they can find their purposes. But guess what? The leader's got it, and I can guarantee you it will turn around. No question about it. Now, those who don't like me, guess what? I'm not in the business of being liked. As a matter of fact, I'm in the business of transformation. So if you don't like me, I'm sorry for you, but it's all right. Okay. Now, next. Number three. The leader is angry. The team is excited. Why? I get in there and the team is not working very well and things are not great. The culture is crap. They're not making sales. Things are not happening. And guess what? Who is responsible? The leader. Hello. The leader is ultimately responsible for that. So I go after the leader. Why? They had closed themselves off. They had, you know, it was like us and them. And they're always saying, you know what? My people are not doing this. My people are not doing this. So I turn around and say, hey, have you stopped to ask yourself a question? Who is in charge here? They say, yeah, but, you know, these guys get paid. They need to do their part. I say, yeah, they need to. But, for example, let me ask you, what is the vision of the organization? Nobody knows. I said, okay, what is the number one thing we're going to do for the next 3 months? Nobody knows. So I say, hey, dude, the problem is you right now, okay? So let us work and make sure this happens. Now, guess what? Obviously, human beings, probably I could have done it easier or better or coerced him and put him in, you know, bathed him a bit and kind of said, oh, baby, sorry, I don't want to bruise your ego. Shut up. You're the leader. You're supposed to get up and do what you have to do. So guess what? 250 people are suffering because you, the leader, are not doing what you have to do. Now, I'm not in the business of doing the right thing for the sake of doing the right thing, because I have to keep the leader. By the way, the leader signs my check. So you can imagine this payment hasn't come through yet. Okay. So, but it's okay. You know why it's okay? I am in the business of making sure that things happen for other people. I'm in the business of making sure that people are inspired to go to the next level. Now, if somebody needs to hear it, then it is my job as a leader from a coaching point of view that I got to do it. Now, some of you are there squirming, saying, oh my God, coach, you're going to lose business. Yes, I would rather lose business of people who are not moving and making a difference than have business and pretending to be somebody else, pretending to allow mediocrity, pretending to what? To say, oh no, you know what? Because the leader is so important, so I got to know. Your job as a leader is to inspire extraordinary action in other people. Your job as a leader is to be a servant leader so that people can come with you to places they've never been. So I am saying right now, if you're not a strong leader who wants to make things happen, do not call me. I quit on you. I don't want to come to your company. Why? Because when I come, you know you're going to get not just stick, but you're going to get something that might not be good for you. Let me tell you why it's not good for you. Number one, it might get you to work harder. Number two, it might make you more money. Number three, it might inspire you to be better than yourself. Number four, you will definitely be transformed. Now, those things might not be good for you, but if they are good for you, guess what? There is a link at the bottom. If you want to get to know what Rapid Influence System is about and how you can take your company to the next level, most importantly, you want to finish strong in 2019 and start big in 2020, then give us a call. Until next time, live strong, live with passion, and know that you have the audacity to live life on your terms. See you. Bye-bye.